I'm sure you remember when we began the trip, we were talking about how the neshama of the Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh came down into the world through the mitzvah of Achnasas Orchim of his father. Right? So we were zoche to have the Nochem's Machnas Orchim here in Uman, and to complete our journey over here by Rabbi Shimon. So we see that Achnasas Orchim brings down very, very big hashpos. So each and every one of us wants to give you a bracha that every single inch, centimeter, millimeter of the home should be filled with only good things. Okay. All the hashpos, taivis, and the schusa, the tzaddikim, the schusa of what you're doing, to be machnes orchem. Hashem is Baruch should always see you as a wonderful guest in his home.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Everything is a little bit, the time today is a little bit matzumtzum, more than usual. But we have to learn, we have to talk about a little bit the stops that we make along the way. I'm going to try to be matzumtzum as much as possible. Already many, many pages that I was hoping to do. Mr. Shum will catch up and it'll be at the reunion. We'll go back go over it. There's much, much, not even half. We didn't do it, even half of what I was hoping. It's because it's unrealistic to be able to expect to do so much with all of the traveling. But to learn a little bit. It's brought down in the Svarim HaKadoshim, the Milo, or the uniqueness of the Tzion of Rabbi Shimon. And this might sound a little bit odd, but it's Beferish in the Zohar Kodesh. But the way that it was at the time of the Beis HaMikdash, when a Jew was able to go to Yerushalayim to be mekabel pnei Shechina, and the Shechina would reach her arms out to him, k'moy chein, and I'm not exaggerating because this is not my words, k'moy chein, bizman hachurban, at the time that we're in now, the time of Golus and Churban, it's possible. There's one place in the world to connect to Kedusha's Beis HaMikdash, to somehow enter into that world of the Beis HaMikdash by the Kever of Rabbi Shimon, by the Tzion of Rabbi Shimon, where we were just zeichet to stand. The Zohar Kodesh in Chelik Beis Lamed Ches, which many of you have heard. I've spoken about this different times over the Helulas, like Ba'omer. By the mitzvah of Lila Regum, the Torah says that every single one comes and is able to see and to be seen by Ha'odan Hashem, by the master of all worlds, Hashem. Man Pnei Ha'odan Hashem. Man Pnei Ha'odan Hashem. What does that mean? Who is Pnei Odan Hashem? Dor Rabbi Shimon by Yochai. Now, to the uninitiated, that sounds a little bit too strong, yeah? Man Pnei Ha'odan Hashem, Dor Rabbi Shimon by Yochai. Who is the face of the master of all worlds that we can connect to in this world, even when everything is destroyed? Dor Rabbi Shimon by Yochai. I'm going to try to explain this a little bit for a few minutes. In the chaveret that you have, there's a longer piece that I would say maybe you could do on the airplane, but you'll probably be very tired. And the Hebrew is a little bit poetic. From the Tzaddik of Hillel Titlin, Hashem should avenge his blood. Where Hillel explains that we know that there are certain tzaddikim that among all of the tzaddikim they stand out as somehow embodying within them Oirei Shel Mashiach. There are tzaddikim who have a very, very powerful, powerful, dominating koach of Mashiach, of Geula. And by these tzaddikim, the whole inyan of Churban Beis HaMikdash, and all that the Churban Beis HaMikdash has wrought, and the changes that have taken place as a result of the Churban Beis HaMikdash, Abachlal, by these tzaddikim, they're not affected by it. They're not affected. One of the great tzaddikim of Chabad is of Isaac al-Homeler, Shusi Yelena. And in Chona Ariel, and Pashas told us, which I was learning through the Parashas of Bereishis this year, it's a very hard cipher. But there was something that I saw that I said that if it was Zaycha to come, I wanted to share with you. And Pashas told us in Chona Ariel, Rabbi Isaac writes, "Ubefrat al pimasha shamati biyichud me'admor nishmosay eden." He says, "I heard with my own ears from the Rebbe, meaning the Alter Rebbe, the Baal Tanya, Shechurban Beis HaMikdash eino elo legabe klolus am b'nei Yisrael. That Churban Beis HaMikdash, the effect of Churban Beis HaMikdash, the impact in Ruchnius of the Churban Beis HaMikdash, is eino elo legabe klolus am b'nei Yisrael, is by Am Yisrael b'chlal. Avu madregis tanoim v'amaroim b'tzadikim hagdolim b'chines Beis HaMikdash lehem lo'olam kayim." He heard these words in Alter Rebbe. However, by Madregis Tanoim and Amaroim and Big Tzadikim, Tzadikim Gedolim, Ha Gedolim, Rabbi Isaacal says that the Bechin of the Beis HaMikdash Shalhem is La'olam Kahim. That by these Tzadikim, there are a few Tzadikim over the generations, that the Bechin of the Beis HaMikdash, by them, never ever dies. The Inyan of Kedushas HaMikdash, the Beis HaMikdash, of Hashuras Hashchina never dies. And because of that, Rabbi Isaacal explains over there in Toldos why there were tzaddikim, and especially we see this in a very, very revealed way by Tamir Yavol Shem. And those who are very, very makush to Pnimius HaTorah, tzaddikim of the Svardim and so on, to the now generation of the Babasali, Shusi and Leina, the Rimnitzer Rabbi and other great tzaddikim, with their nisim gluyim mamash by tzaddikim. And Rabbi Isaacal explains that he heard from the Tanya, because there are Jews, there are tzaddikim who live in that state of chochmi law, where there is no hester at all. These are neshamas of Atzilus, from a very, very exalted place. Shenim shechu zman beis hamikdash, that were allowed into our world, into our crazy world. But they come from a different time and a different place. They come from the world of the Beis HaMikdash. And therefore, Ein HaChurban Master Etzlam. The Churban that causes all of us to be so confused and bewildered and to be lost by these unique tzaddik. It's a very short list. Of course, every Hasidus puts their applies for their tzaddikim to be on the list, but it's muskam. It is a very, very short list. In the words of Hillel Paritcher, who was from the same Beis HaMikdash as Rabbi Isaacal HaMeler, who heard from the same tzaddikim, "Shelifnei neshamos hagavos kamo Rashbi." Loinechrav habayis klal. You hear the words. Shelifnei neshamos hagavohos. That those neshamos hagavohos, kamo Rashbi, like Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai, loinechrav habayis klal. The three tzaddikim are great. The three tzaddikim, who the tzaddikim, who the tzaddikim, l'kulei alma, place in this category, is Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai. Mitzvah Shem, in a little while, we're going to be going to the Arizal. And the Or Shiva Siyom, the Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh, that we were zeichet to be last week. In the piece from Reb Hillel, there's a very, very beautiful and profound discussion of Rabbi Nachman's place in this Merkava that we're talking about, of Jews who are not part of Korban Beis HaMikdash. The Tzemach Tzedek, Schusi Aleinu, heard from his grandfather from the Alter Rabbi, heard from the Balatanya, that Adam Arishan was higher than Rabbi Shimon, the Arizal, and the Baal Shem Tov, but only because the Tanya said by Hashem, Hayi Yetzir Kapav Shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu. He had an advantage that the Metzius was that Adam Arishan was the Yetzir Kapav of Mamish. Whatever that means, that Hashem Baruch Mamish formed the Adam Arishan Kivyocha with his own hands. But the Tzemach Tzedek explains that what his grandfather was saying is that Rabbi Shimon, the Arizal, and the Baal Shem, Nizdakichu Kol Kach, they were so purified, they were so refined, they reached such madrigas, that the only advantage that Adam Arishan had over them was that he was Yetzir Kap of Yisbarach. But in terms of what a human being can accomplish, not having been formed directly in such a way, and to be able to retrace the steps back to Adam Arishan, only these three tzaddikim are unique. Think of the schus that we have, that in one week, maybe Shimon, the Ari HaKadosh, and the Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh. So we need to understand on our Madrega what this means. Really, this is what the whole week has been about, and to try to understand. Pnei Ha'odin Hashem Dor Rashbi. Pnei Ha'odin Hashem is Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai. I want to begin first to talk a little bit in Halacha. We haven't had much time this week to keep our regular storm in learning. In Nigla, Gemara, Mishnayis, regular Seder in learning because of all of our Sivuvim. So I want to begin by spending a little bit in Halacha, for 5-10 minutes, this Inyan. In order to come into this Inyan, to understand this, that these tzaddikim of the Bechina Beis HaMikdash, and what we're doing now, this entire week, was an Avaida of Ali Lerega. Pneiha Odin Hashem, Mamash. I alluded a little bit to this, Lag Boimer, Erev Lag Boimer, and I said, we'll get back to it. I didn't mean to everybody, but we'll get back to it with our chevra here. A few weeks ago, when we learned Vishbati Chayaroim in Haaretz, there's a great haftach, there's a great promise that Hashem Yisbarach has made to us, that He's going to remove all of the dangerous and all the dangerous and violent animals from Eretz Yisrael will be removed. So that includes mostly the ones that were on two legs, not just on four legs. That they will all be removed from the land. In Teres Kahanim, Chazal bring a medrash halach, it's machloikis Rabbi Yehuda and Rabbi Shimon. I'm sure everybody remembers. It's machloikis, what is the meaning of Hishbati Chaya Ra'am and Ha'aretz? What does that mean? I will remove all of the wild animals from the land. So Rabbi Yehuda says, it means exactly what it says. Ma'aviram min ha'olam. It means that they will be physically ousted. All of whatever dangerous animals there are going to be physically removed from Eretz Yisrael. Vishbati chayer ma'aviram min ha'olam, from the world. That's the view of Rabbi Yehuda. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai says, Mashbison Shelo Yaziku. Rabbi Shimon says a fascinating thing. Rabbi Shimon says that it doesn't mean in Pashtus that every violent, every carnivorous animal, whatever it is going to be physically destroyed. But rather, Mashbison Shelo Yaziku. The animals will remain alive, but Yashbiso Shaloy Yaziku. Mashbiso Shaloy Yaziku means that the teva of the animals will be transformed. The teva, the nature of the beasts, will no longer be to harm. In other words, the chomer, the physical reality will remain the same. Maybe Shimon says. The transformation is going to be a metaphysical transformation of sorts, where mashbisan shaleyaziku, the animals will remain, but their nature will be completely transformed. They will no longer be dangerous. The promise of Yimaisa Mashiach Vagar Zaivim Kevis, right? That they'll no longer be dangerous. The animals will be transformed. They will no longer be dangerous. It's machlokes Rabbi Yehuda and Rabbi Shimon. So the Ragachava, just to bring together all that we've been talking about, the Ragachava over there in Fukaisai writes that the machlokes is machlokes real lishitasa. And the Ragachava in his own unique way says, look at the beginning of the second parak of Pesach. What's the beginning of the second parak of Pesach? So there, it's machloik is with the din of biur chametz, of how one needs to fulfill this mitzvah of eliminating the chametz, of biur chametz. So l'shitas of Yehuda, ein biur chametz, what? Ella? Sreifim. Ein b'chametz al esreifa. The chametz has to be physically annihilated. Al pi din ha'tayra, that complete, absolute annihilation in the world that we have can take place through being burned, esreifa. The chachamim and Rabbi Shimon b'nehem disagree. And they hold that mefarah v'zer l'ruach abat aliyah. You don't have to physically annihilate the chametz. You can throw it into the ocean. Or you could throw it into the wind. The crumbs and throw it into the wind. It doesn't have to become ashes. So the Rogatshavah makes a tzustel between the mitzvah of the haftacha, the promise of the Torah, of Vishbati Chaya Ram and Haaretz, that Hashem says, I will remove all of the animals from the world, the dangerous animals, and the mitzvah of Bir Chametz. What's Rabbi Yehuda L'shitasai? According to Rabbi Yehuda, the physical mitzvahs must be removed. The same way that Vishbati Chaya Ram and Haaretz means that the actual animals are going to be destroyed. Come on, gone. No more chayis, rots, no more yishmaelim over here. Finished, gone. So too, when it comes to chametz, the physical mitzias of the chametz has to be completely eliminated. And the way that elimination takes place, al pi Torah is sreifa. The mitzias achomris, the physical matter, has to be destroyed, has to be annihilated. And that takes place only through Sreifa. In other words, Sreifa Sachamez is the bittle of the Chomer, the destruction of that material on earth that's called Chomez. And Rabbi Yehuda L'shitasa, the Rogachova says, holds, Vishbati Chai Rav and Aretz means there needs to be a physical, practical bittle and histalpus of that mitzias of Chaimer. That's called a dangerous animal. And Hashem will kill them, or whatever it is. They'll disappear. That's the end. Rabbi Yehuda doesn't accept allowing the chaymer to exist, so crumbling it a little bit and throwing it in the wind has not brought about that destruction of the chametz. So v'hishbati is a lashon of shvisa, right? Shvisa, like Shabbos, we'll talk about in a minute. And it means the complete end, stopping, bittul, of the chametz and of the animals. Masha'enikein lechachamim v'rabbi Shimon b'neihem. The inyan of Rabbi Shimon is that the chomer is never the ikar. The physical structure, the physical reality is never the ikar by Rabbi Shimon. By Rabbi Shimon who lived in the world of Kodesh HaKadoshim, it's the ikar is never the stones, it's never the structure. The inyan by Rabbi Shimon is always the eichus, the pnimius, the ruchnius, the tzuras adam. It's never about the physical reality. That wasn't the world where Rabbi Shimon lived. And therefore, by Rabbi Shimon, it doesn't make a difference even if the animal continues to exist. Going back to Vishbati Chayi Raman Aris. Even if the actual animal exists, but the tzura of the lion, the tzura of the bear, has been transformed. The inner core, the essence of what it really is, be'etzim, what it is no longer the same. Rabbi Yehuda says, Nishbati Chayirah, Rabbi Yehuda is talking about this world, Nigla, and the practical world of Nigla. I'm not interested in this animal being friendly. I'm not talking about him changing his personality, about Hashem changing his personality, you know, like making this, you know, into a big Lion King or something, a movie, with all the lions that are, you know, give you Shalom Aleichem or something. He's not. Rabbi Yehuda says Vishvati Chayram means Gavi. He's in that world of the practical world of Nigla, and the practical world of Nigla, when Hashem says Vishvati Chayram in Aretz, it means there's no more dead animals. Finished. As far as the Chometz is concerned. By Rabbi Yehuda, it means also ma'aviroi min ha'olam, and the way that we do that is by sreifa. But according to Rashi, according to Rabbi Shimon, the ikur is both by the animal and by the chametz. The ikur is the bitl of the tzura hapnimis. The bitl of the tzura hapnimis. Even if the chumrius is still kayim with the chametz, you haven't changed it into ashes. It's still a piece of bread. And by the animal, it's still an animal. But the siluk, Rabbi Shimon says, is with a person's machshov. When it comes to the chametz, that separation between myself and the chametz, that physical demonstration that I'm the chlal, not machshav it anymore. And I throw it away. And Rabbi Yehuda is screaming, you could throw it away from Habez Morgan. I see this piece of chametz. And Rabbi Shimon says, it's no longer chametz. The same way Rabbi Yehuda says, I see this line, I see this animal. And Rabbi Shimon says, it's not a line anymore. Because Rabbi Shimon's world is a world of nistah. Let me give a more familiar example of this in halacha, which I spoke a little bit in the yeshiva to the guys about. Machloikis Rabbi Yehud and Rabbi Shimon Yochai, the mitzvah of Yom HaShvi Tishbais. But the mitzvah of Shabbos, it's Machloikis Rabbi Yehud and Rabbi Shimon Yochai, Rabbi Shimon. As far as Malachas and Etzich Lagufa is concerned, Rabbi Yehuda, as you know, is Machayev, and Rabbi Shimon is Paitel. By Dovish and Miskave, the Malacha was without the Kavanah for the Malacha, again, Rabbi Yehuda asks, and Rabbi Shimon is Mati. Now you all know why, because Rabbi Shimon is completely focused on a klal, which is a klal by all melachas Shabbos, which is melachas machsheves osratayim. Since by Rabbi Shimon, the ikur is always the pnimius, the tzura, the machshava, the kavana. That's the ikur. Not that he ignores the world, but the ikur is always the machshava. Therefore, Rabbi Shimon says that if a person intends to do this and it comes out that, was bechlal odav shenim eskavein. So Rabbi Shimon, who lives in the world of Nister, in the Kodesh Kodashim, in the world of Pnimius, in the world of the Tzura, of what something really, really is. Rabbi Shimon, it's not called the Melechas Machshavas anymore. Because if the Machshava is missing, when the person does a Melechas and it's Tzvich L'Gufa, felt that this Machshava is missing. The Machshava is not a Machshava to do the Melecha Kedarka. When it's Enim Eskavein, there Rabbi Shimon holds it altogether Mutter. Because the person is bechlal not miskaven to do that malach. Therefore, in the absence of machshava, in the absence of pnimius, in the absence of kavana, in the absence of investing oneself, in the absence of that, Rabbi Shimon says, it's not called a malach. So the Torah says, tishbois, if I have In my mind, if I'm not in that place of the melacha, that's a shvisa. I'm not doing the melacha. Because the machshava, I'm not there, because who am I? I'm not the guf. The guf is a levush. By Rabbi Shimon, I means, like we learned from the Baal Shem HaKadosh, I is who I think I am, is where my thoughts are. Melechas machshavas asvatai. Rabbi Yehuda says, let me tell you, Rabbi Shimon. It's a great thing. And I also come for Lag BaOmer and everything. But Rabbi Yehuda says, listen, in Hilchos Shabbos, I don't know about this, what you're talking about. By me, the Torah says, Tishbais, it means there are things you just can't do. Just like where it means, Hashem says, I'm taking away the bad animals, he's taking them away. And when it means getting rid of the chametz, don't tell me fancy stuff. It means I burn it. There's no more physical chametz anymore. So too, when it comes to a melacha, Rabbi Yehuda says, "A melacha shen tzuchu l'chayit." Why? Because the physical mitzvah is you're doing the melacha. Adav shen miskaven. The reality is, Rabbi Yehuda is reality based, and Rabbi Yehuda is screaming, "There's a world," and therefore, according to Rabbi Yehuda, I don't care if it's any tzuchu l'gufa, it's any miskaven. The mitzvah is. Are you taking this rake and are you taking this table and because you're pulling this table across the ground, are you what? Is there a melacha of charisha? Are you chayrish? You're chayrish. Your intention is not to plow in order to plant. Are you just schlepping the picnic table? Maybe you just, I don't care what your machshav is. This world is a world of maisa, of lamaisa. And in the world of Maisa, what I see when I look at the ground is when you pull the table across the ground, there's a charitz, right? How do you, charitz is a
furrow.
You made that, and that's the melacha of charish. You're charish. You're even some melacha. If Shimon says, yeah, but don't you know why he's doing this? This guy's not plowing. This guy never saw an ox in his life. He's just trying to make a barbecue. He wants to eat the ox. I remember there was a movie that we saw when we were like 40 years ago. It was called The Frisco Kid. You know how silly, you never forget these things. And it was about some like Hasidic Yid that he came to America because he heard about you can make a lot of money on the West Coast with the gold rush. So there was a scene over there with this little guy with a pay. It was a weird, I think it was a Jewish guy in real life too. I don't remember. Oh, so he's a, I don't know if he's alive. He's not alive. It was a long time ago. But he was a crazy looking guy. So he had like the little pay look and they made him, you know, dressed up like a chassid. And he couldn't eat anything, you know. And he came with a chalif with a knife. and this chicken was looking at him funny. And he was trying to go very slowly after this chicken. He knew how to shech this guy. And he wanted to come in, and the chicken was like backing off. And this yid says, "I don't want to hurt you, I just want to shech." That's what he said. "I don't want to hurt you, I just want to slaughter you." So the Yehuda says, look, that's the Metzias. So Rabbi Shimon says, this guy's no Kavana Zachrisha. He's not plowing, he's not just in plowing the cloud. He's not, there's no Zriya, there's no Chrisha, it's garnish. He's just trying to move a table. It's heavy and he's slapping it across the yard. If Rabbi Shimon says, in that world of Machshava, in that world of Nister, in that world of Pnimis, in the Beis HaMikdash, where this person is, be'etzim, where he really is, I can't be mechayiv him in a melacha of chayish. The Torah can't be mechayiv. B'kitzer, according to Rabbi Shimon, the ikur is always the echus, the quality, the etzim, the pnimius, the shayrish adav, always. You can go through every machlokes throughout Shas and Medrash, every machlokes throughout Torah Shabbat. Whenever you have a machlokes, Rabbi Shimon, Rabbi Yehuda, you could understand it according to what we just spoke about. If you don't believe me, you can ask Simchi. He knows all of them. Every machlokes between Rabbi Shimon and Rabbi Yehuda, every single machlokes could be understood according to this, which really, this is just a marmokim from the Rugged Shabbat, what we just spoke about now. It's just psachim perik beis. Rabbi Yehuda l'shitaso, b'yacham es yishbati chayron. Psachim, reish perik beis. But every machlokes in Shas and in Medrash could be understood in this way. The Lashon of Tanya at the end of Kuntres Achron is this. The Hayois Muda Zois Leoi Dei Chayn. The Hayois Muda, this is known to those who are learning Pnimius at Torah. Ki b'chol ha-mitzvahs yesh Pnimius v'chitzoinius. With all mitzvahs, there's Pnimius and chitzoinius. V'chitzoinius, he says, the chitzoinius me'ashabas, hu shvisa me'asiya gashmas. The Tanya says the chitzonius of Shabbos is shvisa me'asiya gashmis, means withdrawing physically from the world, from whatever is defined. The point of Loch is asiya gashmis. K'may she'shobas Hashem me'asiya shemayim v'aretz gashmi. Because the Baruch Shalom, l'maise, the Baruch Shalom stopped creating heaven and earth. Well, the Baruch Shalom stopped being Isaac in gashmis. That's what Shabbos was. That was Shabbos, as far as the nigla of Shabbos. Then the Alter Rebbe goes on, O pnimius haShabbos, he bekavona betfilas haShabbos, betamatar ledovka b'Hashem echad. But that's not the pnimius of Shabbos. The Rebbe Shimon of Shabbos, the Nister of Shabbos, the Beis Hamikdash of Shabbos, is what? The tfilas, the kavonas, tamatar ledovka b'Hashem echad, k'may shekosuv, Shabbos l'Hashem elokecha. Shabbos l'Hashem elokecha. V'zui b'chines zocha. ובחינס שומו בפנימיוס יאשוויסו מדיבורם גשמיים כמו ששובס השם עשו מאמור שניברו בהם שמיים ואורץ גשמיים כי זה לומה זה עושה הלוקים. There was more time, we're going to that more, this piece of the Tanya. It's at the end of Kuntres Achron. So what I wanted to just explain by that little inyan in halacha is going back to the beginning. The same way that all that we see throughout Nigla, in the world of Nigla, the revealed Torah, that Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai is the bechina of what? Beis HaMikdash. Is the bechina of Pnimius. In the same way that in Chitzonius, in the physical world, by the entire world, the Beis HaMikdash is in ruins. But by Rabbi Shimon and the tzaddikim who are a hemshech of Rabbi Shimon, those extraordinary Ari HaKadosh, Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh, Rabbi Nachman, even though the physical structure has been eliminated from the world, the Metzias HaChomris is no longer here, but the Tzura HaPnimis is Chai V'Kai, because that's the world that they live in. We take momentary little trips into that world, and even then, we just scratch a little bit beneath the surface. But there are tzaddikim b'chinas Mashiach. who are shining with Eirish al Mashiach, that they mamish live every minute of their lives, every second of their lives. They live mamish in a Metzias that's built in Nechreves, that cannot be destroyed. They live in a Metzias of Bar Yochai B'Kodesh HaKadosh. The words that we just said, Bar Yochai B'Kodesh HaKadosh. Now listen to this. A few weeks ago, we read in the Teichacha, in Leitishmuli, a lot of upsetting things that have already befallen, halavai, should already be all finished. Things that have happened to us in Leitishmuli. There's a maimer in the Zohar Chodesh at the beginning of Parshas Kisavah. Which I didn't notice, I thought it was going to be too much. At the beginning of Parshas Kisavah, we're taught that Rabbi Shimon and Rabbi Lozhin, now we're familiar with the Gemara on Shabbos, the Gemara of Lag Boimer, of how Rabbi Shimon and Rabbi Lozhin had to run away from the Romans and so on, and that Maru, which is not far from here, and they were hiding there in all the Nisim and whatever happened with the cave and coming out of the cave and the Gemara and so on, the whole story. We're very familiar with that. The Zohar Chodesh tells us that that was not the only time the Rabbi Shimon, that was not the only time or place that Rabbi Shimon and Rabbi Lozhin were hiding. The Zohar tells us that they had to run to Midbar Lod. They ran to the Midbar of Lod, and they were hiding also there in a ma'ar, in a cave. And over there, it says in the Zohar that they were learning Keseder, Reb Shimon and his son Reb Elazar were learning with Eliyahu Navi. The Zohar goes on and tells us that if you have a chance, when we go back to Beis Medrash, to look in the Zohar Chodesh at the beginning, of Yisavah, it says that one day, the Chaveirim, meaning Rabbi Shimon's Chevra, that the Chaveirim, who were not with him, and they didn't know where he was, that the Chaveirim were learning in the Beis Medrash, and they came to the parasha of the klolos of the curses in Mishneh Torah in Devarim, in Parashat Kisavah. And they were very, very taken by the fact that when you look in Kisavah, there's a very obvious difference between the klolos, the curses of Kisavah, and the curses that we just learned in the Bechukaisai. And the very obvious difference is that in Bechukaisai, Mitten Derinin, there are beautiful promises of Hashem, that show Hashem's love for us. Otherwise, we feel like we're mamish going to die before the klolos, or God forbid, even brought upon us, chalila. But over there in Bechukaisai, the Baruch Shalom interrupts and says, Av zois, av gam zois berehayois, berehayois, veyem, loy maastim, loy gaaltim, chaloisem, lo afir brisi yitav, vizachartis brisi, avram, and so on. So in the klolos of Bechukaisai, the Chavrai of Rabbi Shimon said, in the klolos of Bechukaisai, there we see Befeirish, what the Baruch Shalom says, yeah, but I'm Bemis, I mamish love you. And I'll explain this to you some other time. But I really love you. And he tells us these psukim, we have these psukim, the most beautiful psukim in the Chumash. Zacharti is B.C.R. It's B.C.R. The most beautiful pasuk in the Chumash. Masha'ena came. In the Teichacha of Kisavai, over there, when you look in Kisavai, there's no Nechama at all. It's just boom, mamish, klolos. The whole thing is klolos. And what was even more painful was, as these chachamim pointed out, the tzaddikim pointed out, is that we know that the klolos of the first teichacha in Bechukaisai are connected to bayis rishon, right? Rabban. Connected by his reach. And the klolos and kisava are what? Connected by his sheni, which means this galus. So the chachamim were overwhelmed with pain. in the earlier klalas of a chukais that correspond to the first galus. So then the Baruch Shalom says, Yidden, it's going to be okay, and he gives us nechama. But we're not in that galus now. We're in the second, we're in Chum Beis HaMikdash by Sheini, galus Edayim. And in the galus of Edayim, the chachamim are saying that they, over there we don't find in the klalas that there's any, there's not a nice word. There isn't any nechama at all. Come, Rabbi Yehuda Bar Eloi. I'm reading from the translation from Aramis into the Hebrew, from the Masech Midrash. Come, Rabbi Yehuda Bar Eloi, v'omar chaval al chesreina shabai yochai shechosalon. Rabbi Yehuda Bar Eloi said, "Oh, it's so terrible that by Yochai the Rabbi Shimon is not here with us." Ve'imish yedem imenu. And we don't know what happened to him. And if we would know where he is, if anybody would know where he is, he wouldn't be allowed to say where he is. So the Zohar goes on and tells us that Rabbi Yosi, Rabbi Yehuda sent a yoina, a dove. He sent a bird with this question in the bird's mouth. And it was sent b'shlichus. We find in different places in Chazal that Knesset Yisrael is compared to a Yonah, right? Yonosi Tamosi, Yonosi B'chag V'yaselah. So when we see in different places that when Am Yisrael is in pain, we see that when Am Yisrael is in pain, and Am Yisrael is frightened, that the Indian of the Yonah is a to'elus, somehow. And can somehow get the message across where it, and bring it to where it needs to go, like with Yonah, like with Noach and the Yonah, and so on. So Rabbi Yosef Yehuda sends this Yonah, Shlichus, to Rabbi Shimon. Go find Rabbi Shimon. You know where Rabbi Shimon is. And sends the Yonah Shlichus and brings in its mouth this letter with the question to Rabbi Shimon Baruchai, and says there in the Zohar Chodesh, that Rabbi Shimon reads the letter and he begins to cry. And he says, Boicha ani al shenefrashti min achavei. I'm crying that I've been separated from my chaver. V'ani boichel al dvarim elu shenem niglum lehem. And I'm crying that they don't see what's going on over here. Al dvarim, that they're reading the klolos, they're looking at the curses of this world, that Hashem has brought cursed us, and all they're seeing is what? The nigla. They're looking at this, at the misery of this world, the klolos in the Kisavai, and all they see are the klolos. When he boich al dvar meilush and him niglim lahem. Ma yasu had doros ha-achroin them im yistaklu b'ze. So Bishimon said, what's going to happen to the later generations, meaning us, all the later generations who are living during this terrible, long, long galus, and they're going to open up Torah and they're going to see the klolos, and the klolos have no necham in them. And the klolos don't have any brachas. So Bishimon's crying because he misses the chaveir. And he understands that because he is no longer with the Chavayim, that they don't get it. And all they see are the klolos, and they don't see the nister of the klolos. They don't see what's hidden in the klolos. They just see the shetach, the surface. They don't see. In the meantime, the Zohar says, everybody's awake, you okay? Elyonovi comes. Elyonovi comes over there. He was there. Elyonovi was there all the time. Elyonovi comes, and he says, Shalchani HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he says, Rabbi Shimon, Hashem has sent me to help you with your crime. To help you to calm down. And he begins to say, aha, aha, Rabbi Shimon. And the Zohar is so moving, just the description there. You look in the Zohar Chodesh at the beginning of Kisav. And it says over there that Rabbi Shimon couldn't be consoled, and Elyonov couldn't even get, Rabbi Shimon was crying so much, he fell asleep, it says, by the opening of the Mar. Rabbi Shimon fell asleep. Elionavi comes over and he says, Kum Rabbi Shimon, his Urim Ishinascha. Kum Rabbi Shimon, Rabbi Shimon, get up, wake up. Ashrei Chelkecha. Remember, Rabbi Shimon is the one who's supposed to be awake, Ir V'Kadesh. Ashrei Chelkecha. Elionavi says to Rabbi Shimon, Ashrei Chelkecha, Shakadosh Baruch Hu Roitze B'Kvoidcha. That HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants, Roitze B'Kvoidcha, he wants your glory and your honor. And now, and Elionavi brings straight from Hashem's Baruch. Kol ha'avtochus v'anachomu shel Yisrael, k'suvim be'el ha'klolus. The biggest brachas. Listen to the lashon. I'm just translating from the Masech Midrash. Kol ha'avtochus v'anachomu shel Yisrael. You want to understand why old Jews are running to this place. When we were walking out, there were two ladies coming. There was an old one and there was a young one. Probably this is the mother and this is the daughter, both wearing pants. Shmat is on the head with the pants. And she's, the mother's yelling at the daughter, Tembel, shachach the tanderot, shachach the tanderot. You idiot, you forgot the candles, you forgot the candles. Ani ba, im, ani ba, od mat, ani ba. She had the candles, maybe Shimon. She's coming from Givatayim somewhere. Do I know where she's coming from? Ramat Gan, who knows? Could be much further. Kol ha'avtochus v'anachomus Yisrael k'suvim be'elu ha'klovus. All of the promises, all that's good, all that's ever going to be, is coded into the klovus. Say u'ra'ei. Melach she'oyev es benoi. And Elionavi reveals to Rabbi Shimon, Melach she'oyev es benoi, a father who loves his son, afa pisha kololoi v'yiko, even though it could be said some hard words, and he gave him a patch. Ahavas me'ov olov. Ahavas me'ov. His kishk, his, the inner essence of who he is, the father, is madly in love with the kid. And even when he shows, kas, anger, rachmim shaloyolov, it's filled with rachmim. Kacha kadosh baruch hu. So with Hashem, afa pisha kol, even Hashem's baruch has cursed, has written these curses in his Torah. Dvarav heim ba'ahava, every single word is be'ahava. Begolui heinirais klolois. I'm just reading from the Zarchot. On the outside, they appear as curses. The hein toivais gedolois. But in pnimius, be'etzem, in truth, hein toivais gedolois, the biggest toivs. Mishum she'elu haklolos hoyu bahava, mashlo hoyu kein beklolos harishainis. And not only that, the second set of klolos, of our klolos, in Parshas Kisavoy, Elionavi says to Rabbi Shimon that the ahava, those who are mi ahava, much, much bigger than what Mashaloi haya came with klolos harishoinis, the ones in Vayikrin, Chukaisai, Shekulo hayu bedin kosha, the dinim were stronger dinim in the Chukaisai, where it says over there, Va'av gam zois be'eretz oyveyim, loy ma'astim, where it says nice words. The Toichacha in Vayikra, Elionavi says to Rabbi Shimon, the Hataka was Dinam Kashim, stronger Dinam. Amalei Rabbi Shimon. So Rabbi Shimon says to Elionavi, Be'ezem Mokim Nizgal Sagulis Yisrael B'Klolos Eilu. He saw this in Eserot. So Rabbi Shimon asks Elionavi, in these klolos of Kisavo that you now taught me that are hidden the greatest brachas, where is the bracha of Mashiach? Where is the bracha of Geula? Omaloi yistakil v'habei b'mokim harabi yoisa mikola klolos shomhu. He says to him, Elinavi says, look in what you think is the worst place in the klolos, the worst. Shomhu, that's where Mashiach is. That's where Gula is. Shomhu, in that place. In that pasuk. The end of this story is that Rabbi Shimon sends the Yonah, sends the dove back to the Chaveir with this whole shakla v'tarya, with the whole story of what happened. He sends it back to them. And first, when the Chaverim got this, the bird returned with a note from Rabbi Shimon. So first they had a hisarus that even when Rabbi Shimon is not here, how much we're able to learn from him. Even though we're not zoichet to have him with us, we're still learning from him. That was Aleph. The Maimer ends with the following. Ashrei nafshei shel bar Yochai. Ashrei nafshei shel bar Yochai. Shekadosh Baruch Hu osoi imay nisim. That Hashem's Baruch has performed miracles. And here, they're not talking about birds bringing him food to eat. Those kind of nisim. Water coming, a spring of water from nowhere. That's not what they're talking about. Ashrei nafshei shel bar Yochai, Shekadosh Baruch Hu osoi imay nisim. That nobody like Rabbi Shimon to part to the whole world from din. And Rabbi Shimon is going to be Rosh Letzadikim who are sitting in Gan Eden. The Kabul Pnei HaShchina, to receive the face of the Shchina. The Yiras HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and no one like Rabbi Shimon is going to see Hashem as clearly. V'yishtasheim HaTzadikim v'yayim alaham, bo nishtachve v'nichra nivrucha l'fnei Hashem HaYisayin. And Rabbi Shimon is going to invite all of the other Tzadikim who ever lived into that place of Pnei HaShchina to say, bo, chevre, bo nishtachve v'nichra nivrucha l'fnei Hashem HaYisayin. So this chevre now, coming to a regular, nice little, normal chevre, plain chevre. From Woodmere and the environs. The whole inyan of Rabbi Shimon is Or HaGadlus. The whole inyan of Rabbi Shimon, to understand and what this entire week has been about, and our effort to try to somehow connect to this inyan, this sugya, of Meleches Machshavos, of the brachas that are genuzos. If you review in your minds, or later on, in any other way, all that we've been learning together, all that we've been talking about from the beginning, from the Kedushas Levi, which we didn't have the chance to learn, that piece that Mitzvah learned in the city, of the inyan of Adayin, the person believing that he still has a chance to change, I could still change. And everything that we spoke about by Reb Nosson and then by in Uman, in Meshbiz, it's all this same Nakuda. What's the first Maimer of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai in Shas? The first maimers and brachas hayman aleph that everybody knows. Tanya Rabbi Shimon v'Yochai Oimer Shalosh Matanis Tovus Nosan Kadosh Baruch Hu Yisrael. And now we're coming to the conclusion of our trip together. Shalosh Matanis Tovus Nosan Kadosh Baruch Hu Yisrael. V'kulon loy nosnon ela ida yisur. There are three precious gifts that Hashem has given to us, but they can only be received through suffering and difficulty. Elohein Torah Eretz Yisroel Olam Haba. Everybody knows the Gemara. Torah Eretz Yisroel Olam Haba. So who's going to bring to you and I, when we go through our difficulties, the Jews of God forbid go through terrible difficulties, who's going to send from Rabbi Shimon a little dove, a little Yonah? Can you imagine a person who, God forbid, sees a child going off the derech? Or a person who, God forbid, is in the hospital, or someone that he loves is in the hospital? Or a person whose marriage is falling apart, and he doesn't know, a poshet doesn't know how he's going to be able to live. Who's going to send him a little yon, a little bird, a little dove, to come with a note, mamish, straight from Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai? And Rabbi Shimon is saying to this person, that you should know that the place where it's the most difficult time of your life, what you see as the greatest klala of your life, what you see as the most bitter moment of your life, if you're able to reach into that place of who you are, because you're zoche to learn Pnimis HaTorah and you live in the world of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, to try to be in that place of the Shechina with Rabbi Shimon. If a Jew is in that place, then even though we don't receive a physical letter from Rabbi Shimon, Torah, Eretz Yisroel, Olam Haba, all those things that are important to us in this world, and we have to go through terrible, terrible difficulties in order to receive, and so it is with everything in life. The same way that in the most difficult klolos, there Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai sent word to Melianovi as the biggest brachas. Rabbi Shimon is teaching each and every one of us, is telling each and every one of us, is sending that note with each and every one of us. And there's the klolos ha'inyan of Rabbi Shimon, of the Ari HaKadosh, and the Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh, and Rabbi Nachman. So that every single moment of your life is a matana toiva, is a precious gift. And if you think the precious gift of life is the one that you enjoyed most, like being like, you know, on a raft, someplace in a separate pool, you know, sipping on a pina colada or something, while watching the Yankees, like, beat the Mets in the World Series. I'm trying to think of something that can't get better, you know, whatever. It's like, and you're just in that place, and you say, Baruch Shalom, I want to thank you for this gift. It's such a great gift you're giving me. Maybe in the world of Rabbi Yehuda. Not to compare tzaddikim, chas v'shalom, I'm saying in that, l'shitasa, in that world that you see with your eyes, those are the matanas of life. I've shared with you this, for many of you, it's not the first time that you've heard this, but many years ago, I was going through certain inyanim and emunah when I was in that, and I was still bacher. And I had been reading some books of apikorsis, and I was having problems, sveikas and things like that. I didn't have anyone to talk to about that. I spoke to my father about it. I wasn't going to go anywhere else. And all my father told me was this. He didn't get into any theology. My father just said that he started to talk to me about how what it was like in the cattle car when they were being taken to concentration camp. I didn't know where he was going with that. That was part of my problem, that my father was in a cattle car. Isn't such a person, why did he have to go through that? And my father said that there was a yid in the cattle car. I don't remember, it was Shabbos, I think, Friday night or something. There was a yid, the night past the Rav, my father remembers. There was a big tzaddik there in the cattle car. That was together, everybody knows what they had to go through in those cars. Most of the people died by the time they opened it. And this tzaddik, my father said, "Oi, what we had over there with this, with the Naipes Derav. Oi, Shabbos with the Naipes Derav." And I'm listening to this. I don't know what I was talking about. He starts to say, he was a gewaldige balmanagin about tefillin. And we had such a lachadoidi, such a yisoyrus, my father said. I never had in my life such a yisoyrus. I know, he didn't answer. I asked him, I'm telling him I'm having problems with my emunah. He starts telling you about somebody. And then my father just said, you know, he just walked away. Something like that. And so I decided I was not going to let this go like that. So I pushed it. And I don't remember, it was the next day or two or something. So I asked my father, I said, tell me, Dad, That tzaddik that sang the Chadoidi, Alep Noch, that tzaddik, he's alive. Did he make it to the gas chambers or something alive? Or what happened to him? So my father said, no, he went up in smoke. So I asked my father, so what's so gewaldig about the Lachadayt? What was such a great davening over there? So my father said to me then was, listen, what I wanted you to understand is that time that I was in that place was the greatest time of my life, was the holiest time of my life. He said it wasn't the best time of my life. It was the worst time of his life. Ever since then, thank God, he's had a lot of gifts. We have a couple of them sitting here. He said, I never ever in my life have been able to feel as close as I did to Kadosh Baruch Hu. I was never, ever, ever able to feel in such a way that there's nothing, there's only him, and that I'm completely, and my entire existence is completely his, not mine. He didn't say in those words exactly, he said, but that's what he said to me. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai taught us how to translate the dinim, the klolos, and the brachas. He taught us how to translate the outside into inside. He taught us to translate what seems to be disregard or even hatred into love. He taught us a different way of thinking, a different way of breathing, a different way of looking at everything. You remember that we just learned that Elion Avi told Rabbi Shimon that the truth is that the first Taichacha, that's worse. Right? That's Dinim Kosh. It's brought down in the Svarim, I don't remember where I saw this, that if you look at the last word, and this try to tie everything together. If you look at the last word in the Taichacha B'chol Kaisa, the end of the clothes of B'chol Kaisa. Remember, B'chol Kaisa is Dinim Kasha. I even know it says something nice in the middle, but Elinovi says it's bad, bad. The last word over there, the pasuk is Ve'eshbor Moitais Olcha. I'll break. Ve'eshbor Moitais Olcha. The last word at the end of the Taichacha is Ve'olech Eschem Kamimius. That's how it ends the whole Taichacha. Ve'olech Eschem Kamimius. So we were singing a song about coming back to Eretz Yisroel, Kom Miyus La'Aretzeinu. Kom Miyus, more about Vasa. Kom Miyus means Shtei Komot. Two floors, Shtei Komot. That's what Kom Miyus means. V'hu Yoluchenu Kom Miyus La'Aretzeinu. Listen, I know I went over the time limit, but... Yes, I'm in charge of the trip here. So what are you going to do? V'olech eschem kominius. V'olech eschem kominius. Listen to the words. Eshba moitois ulchem v'olech eschem kominius. V'hu yolecheinu kominius la'atzeinu. Hashem Shabbat brings us back to Eretz Yisrael. And that we're all going to be back in Eretz Yisrael, every Jew, all of us. But who yelichinu komimius la'atzeinu, there are two ways of getting back. There are different ways. You can go, there's one program that's called One Floor. And they're beautiful Jews. Beautiful Tyre. One Floor, that's the world of Nigla. You just live in the revealed world of Nigla. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful world. Kol hakavod. There's another option. of how to come back to Eretz Yisrael. The difference is that this option allows you, even when you're in Chutz Laaretz, to sometimes make a trip to Eretz Yisrael. We're talking about everybody being sad and worried and depressed when we return to Chutz Laaretz. For who yale chayim akom yumiyus laaretz, any means that Rabbi Shimon taught us that there are two kindness to everything. Rabbi Yehuda was talking about floor, the first ground floor. Ground floor, that's what Yehuda was talking about. What you see. And what you see, klolos are klolos and brachas are brachas. Gifts are things that I understand. It's a gift. It's a good thing. Something bad, it looks to me like it's bad, that's not a gift. That's not a gift. A good place to live is in the five towns. A bad place to be is in Mauthausen or Auschwitz. It's a bad place. Means that the return that we've made on our little trip from a very, very difficult place in Golis, with a many tzaddik, but a difficult place in Golis. And to have the schus to return, and this is only to prepare for the ultimate return to Shem, which will be able to be permanent, is to come as Jews that live on two floors. Not to be Jew that lives on one floor. To be Jews that live on two floors. Now, when you're a Jew that lives on one floor, the second that you leave Israel airspace, you're no longer in Eretz Yisrael. When you leave the Chevra, and we have to, each one has to go back, the Kamer, the Gafna, whatever, to go back to his vineyard and to his into his place, to his destination of Chutz Laaretz. Every we have to go to work and so on and so forth. So in the world of in the program of one floor, everything has fallen apart. Nisparka hachavila. Everything has fallen apart, and all you're left with is some nice pictures. And oh, it was a nice thing, something that was. It's an interesting thing that I've seen so often. There are people that I've gone through life with that are wonderful, wonderful Jews who live on that one floor and they do their best, and they're much better than me in a million ways. I'm not saying they're not good. They're great people. But when you try to talk to them a little bit about the second floor, they're not so interested. But they say, they'll always preface by saying, no, I know. Maybe Shimon, I understand. And you say to Baal Shem, you know, they always say something like that. The truth is that the old Misnagim, they were much more honest. They just said right out, nah, it's not. But nowadays, most people say, ooh. But it's not. Ain lanu what? Chelek? Ben Estaros. Ain lanu chelek ben Estaros. So I have seen that that statement of Ain lanu chelek ben Estaros holds true by these people as long as they're not suffering. But once they get those gifts, once the Teichah falls upon them, then all of a sudden, you know, I get a phone call. What was that you were saying about Tanya? You have an extra cup? What was the name of that big rabbi again? Oh, the Lev Yitzchak from Adichin. All of a sudden, the Jew that spent his whole life, and usually, very often, not usually, comes with a lot of Yeshus and Gaiva too. I know everything. That's not important. But it's interesting. When the klolos fall upon lo aleinu, should be on any Jew, should be on our enemies. And the exterior begins to fall apart, and he doesn't know how to go on living. Then a remarkable, remarkable thing happens. He gives a peek to that window that I was talking about last night, and all of a sudden he sees that there's a komashnia, and he doesn't know how to get there, but he wants to get to the komashnia, to the second floor, because now if he lives on the first floor, he's going to die. Without Rabbi Shimon, you can't breathe. The difference is that when you live that way, when things are well, also, you don't, doesn't have to be just to wait chas v'chalila till God forbid it, there are klolos, because in life there are klolos. But it means to be able to see the brachas of our lives in a way that's with two levels, that has two floors. So look inside and we'll finish now. On page 38, we're not going to go over, we'll just do a line, we'll do a few lines. It's an Hakdama at the beginning of the Zohar, and Daf Daled. He's talking about when Shimon died. Right, we'll go straight downstairs over there for the, we'll just do it in the Moshe Midrash. Ishtatach Rabbi Chiya Ba'ar. Ishtatach Rabbi Chiya Ba'ar. Oh, Ishtatach Rabbi Chiya, Ishtatach Rabbi Chiya Ba'ar. Ishtatach V'ispashad Rabbi Chiya La'aretz Al Kivra Shal Rabbi Shimon. Rabbi Chiya threw himself upon the grave of Rabbi Shimon. V'noshak is Ofer Kivra. I'm just reading straight the Hebrew translation. And he kissed the dirt. He was kissing the dirt. And he was crying and he said, Ofer, Ofer, kamak she'oref at. Earth, dirt, you're so stubborn. You know that dirt that's preventing us from getting to the second floor? Because really the emesis would be Shim and Eschai V'Kayim. That's what this whole Shtigl Zohar is about. Earth that blocks, kamak she'oref at. You're such a machutz, physical reality. You hear what Rabbi Chiya is saying? Physical reality. You're so machutz. Shekol machmedei ha'ayin nishchasim b'cha. The most beautiful and sweetest things in the world, you destroy. The earth. Earth doesn't just mean when someone gets buried. It means the earthliness of superficiality and shallowness of seeing everything just for what it is. You destroy everything. And you grind the bodies of the tzaddikim. You take and you destroy the bodies of the tzaddikim. You're such a mechutzefes, the earth. A kibbutzina kadisha to have a nohir alma. The holy light, Tamora, Kodesh, Rabbi Shimon, Shabbat, there also, Hayamakayim, Ameyus, Ailamach, Lanirus, Akeshus, Biomav, the holy light, Rabbi Shimon, who lit up the entire world, and during his life there was never a rainbow. Shalit de Ravrava Miman. Shayashol, the Mumunabel Yonim Saktam, he was ruling over not only this world, he was ruling over all of the angels above. The Schuse Mikayim alma. That his Torah, Rabbi Shimon's Torah, is mekayim the entire world. Izbelibach, gam hu meis v'nigver v'nizbelibach. You also have swallowed up Rabbi Shimon. Achaka adibar Rabbi Chiya l'noichir Rabbi Shimon, and then Rabbi Chiya speaks directly to Rabbi Shimon. This goes back to what we were talking about. They speak directly to the person who was nifter, which is the Messiah of the Zohar Kodesh. There are many Bekaris like that. Rabbi Shimon, the Hiru Butzin, and the Hiru Dal. Rabbi Shimon, Shata, Or Hamor. The Or, next page 39. The Or Kol Ha'ilom is light of all worlds. Am Boli Ba'afrat, the Boli Ba'afr. Some Af Alpi Shata Kvarmes. Vim Kolze. But then Rabbi Chiya says, Your body is deteriorating in the earth. The earth is terrible. And it's taking your holy body. And it's causing your holy body to deteriorate, to disintegrate. At the Bola Ba'ofer, right? Va'ant kayim. But you're alive. V'noheg alma. Manheg es ha'olam. Doesn't mean, God forbid, there's a Baruch Shalom. But da, Rabbi Shtar Rashbi, that your Torah is manheg es ha'olam. Ha'ili chaynu kamim yus la'aretz ayinu. Kal yidei shaloim dima amarecha shifts. The Moshe Midrash explains. Your lips are moving in the grave. Rabbi Chiya was like mishtoimim. He was bewildered. He was mamish like shocked.
And then he says, Afra, Afra, loites goy. Afra, Afra, loites goy. You, the earth, dirt, don't be proud of yourself. Don't think that you're going to win. You're not going to win.
Dilo yismashun b'chamud da'alma. Shlo yimsu b'cha amud ha'olam.
Because the pillars of the world, Rav Shloimeh, had tzaddikim ha'gedolim, what we're talking about. Rabbi Shimon by Yochai, the Ariya Kodesh, and the Baal Shem Tov Kodesh, Rabbi Nachman, these tzaddikim, you're not going to be able to swallow them up. Only their bodies. But we pass like Rabbi Shimon.
Rabbi Shimon loy izbeli bach. Rabbi Shimon loy nivle bach. Rabbi Shimon vada loy gor Rabbi Shimon machai ba yoishia and izkim zecha Shabbos
and so on, who's not going to be swallowed up and taken and destroyed by the earth. Therefore, Rabbi Shimon said, Chas v'shon loy tishtachach Torah Yisrael, loy tishtachach, it says in Torah, loy tishtachach mipizaro, the Torah will never be forgotten. It means that, of course, the body can be hurt, the body can be damaged. But there's nekuda of Rabbi Shimon bar Yochai inside of a Jew. Every one of us has inside of us a nekuda of Rabbi Shimon. And that nekuda of Rabbi Shimon that lives on the second floor, that lives kamimius, that nekuda of Rabbi Shimon is that which keeps us alive and helps us somehow to be able to come to terms with the yisurim of this world and to be able to hear Rabbi Shimon saying that these are gifts. These are gifts that Hashem is giving you. These are the deepest, most precious moments of your life. And because of that, we have the koach of ruach nachayin chadesh bekirbi to be able to experience these chadshes that we're all longing for. Hashem Yisbach should help us. That we should be zeichet to see the light of Rabbi Shimon shining through that ceiling that separates between these two floors. Toyer Eretz Mikvei Decha. That this physical world should be shining with the covet of Rabbi Shimon, with the covet of the Tzaddikim, with the covet of the Shechina, with the covet of Hashem Yisbach. Toyer Eretz Mikvei Decha. So that we'll be able to come finally to that time. Amen. 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 Amen.